the maximum available offense. But I usually will go. So this is the last thing you will do. Listen, when it comes to wholesaling, don't ever maximum available offer. This is just this fucking show. Like, this is your last resort, right? If you gotta be like, oh, damn, well, the last thing I can do for you is 84 flat. But to be realistic, bro, I'll say if I were to offer this bitch anything, you already want 55, bro. If I wanted to offer this bitch anything, it'll probably be about 40, bro. So you can either time this by
27. You can do 40 and then 40 profit. 40K. So you can do 80, right?
Yeah. So that's how you find them. So hold on, bro. Look, I'm gonna send you a free course, all right? When I first started,
yeah.
Hold on. For free, bro. So let me go to my DMs real quick.
Nah, I kinda did understand a little bit, yo. You really helped me though.
It takes process, bro. You ain't gonna get it fast, bro.
Mm-hmm.
I'm trying to find this nigga. Hold on. This all we talk about, bro. Hopefully, no gay shit come up, bro. This nigga
fucking dick. Gay porn. So I had to find the part where you did the price divided by the square foot, and then you got 7.2, then you did 768 divided by 7.2. Right.
I got you, mom. I fucking find this shit, bro. God damn, man, he touched too much. God damn. You go there. I found that shit. All right, bro. So let me copy this shit real quick. Let me give you no. Hey, this shit, it got all answers, bro. Got fucking. Try to do the ARV. Let's go on T-shirt. For free ski too, bro.
Bad, bro. Appreciate that. Wait, can you go back to the one we're doing the calculation? I got the step right. I was lost at the other step because you went way too fast. You were going slow, but then. So look, can you over? Can you do 555K and then the 7 divided by 768?
Look.
So you do divided by 768, which is the square foot. And then you got, okay, so then you put 7.2, right? I mean 72.
72 is the price per square footage.
Just make it accurate. Yeah. And then you do
my time. About 768.
Wait, hold on. Wait, this is where I fucked up right here. This is why this shit got wrong, because I fucking divided. Fucking dumb. So you did.
Oh,
so after that, you did 72. I keep saying point. I'm done. Times 668.
So this is the price per square foot, and then this is the square foot, right? And this is the estimate of the house. This is what you're gonna get. You understand? So this bitch is actually right about the house being. So what you're gonna go over from here is after you get that down. This is what I did. I looked at the house and I was going to be a little realistic about it. And I said, yeah, I want to do 65. That's probably how much I'll invest into the property.
The
65,000, yeah. So you do 550, 550, right? 96,000 plus 60.
Repair, right?
Yeah, this is the after repair part. Right, this is what you get. You understand? This is after repair price. This is what you're going to tell your buyer when he says, what's the ERV? As far as this goes, you have to find houses similar to this one so you can comp it. So I'll teach you that a little later.
Yeah.
But
wait, I just wrote it like how you showed me. Should I write it like, should I write it like first step, second, and then how many steps is it?
Bro, it's dead ass not even about steps, bro. It's really about going along. But, I think it takes me about three. You know. It takes about 3 seconds.
Let me try one more time, bro. I'm going to write the steps. For real, for real.
All right, look.
Like, I do get the calculations, but I'm not fucking writing the steps. Let me go slowly. Let me write the steps. This fucking pen don't work. All right, go. So.
First step is to get the estimate.
Yeah, estimate.
House. Yeah, so you get the house, and this bitch is 55 gross, and you'd be like, oh, 55 right here. Bam. Divided.
All right.
Square. You understand?
Okay, wait. Stay there. Price. Stay there. Don't press it yet. Price. The square foot.
Divided by the square footage. This is defined the price per square footage. You know what I'm saying? So you do the estimate.
So you're doing that to find the price of what?
The per square footage. So how much it will be to build a house fucking 768 square foot. You know what I'm saying? So end up being, my fault, 1 second. This will end up being 71. But I do 72 to make the price a little accurate. You know what I'm saying?
72 and the 72. What is it 72 for?
72 to make the price a little accurate. Because ARV, when it comes to ARV, you don't wanna be wanna be under, you don't wanna be too over.
But so, I have a question. The 72, so when you divided the money with the square foot, you got 72, but what is the 72%? What does it mean?
Price per square footage.
Oh, okay.
Yo, what's happening?
Right, so,
what's happening, guys?
Oh my God.
Just got back. Hold
up. Get up on Google real quick, my boy. You know what I'm saying? So, look. Say this curve right here. Bam. So, I don't have the fucking estimated value on this bitch. But look how much of the square footage is. $59. You know what I'm saying? This is what you look
for. Oh, that's how much. That's how much you got to pay a square foot. And you're seeing if it adds up, right?
Yeah, most definitely. Yes.
Okay, so go back to the other one, because now I understand, bro. Just go back to the other one. Don't get me confused. All right.
72. So I went from 72, and I'm times this to make sure this price is accurate.
So the 72, per, that's just one square foot, right? That's how much is one square foot, right?
For sure.
Right?
Yeah. I'm 72 price per square footage by the square footage to make sure the estimate is accurate.
And the total, so it's 72 dollars for each square foot, and then now you're gonna multiply it plus the total, right?
Yeah. So you multiply the price per square foot.
Yeah. All right, now I got that. And then now what? Let me see.
Okay, and you get. And then that's when you add your repairs and you get your ARV. Then
what is that called? Is that after repair?
No. This is the estimate of this is the ARV right here. I'll show you what the ARV is. ARV is when you add the repair price. So we said 65 for the add the repairs, right?
65. So the first one. So wait, don't click it yet. So the first. So the calculation we did at first. That's the estimate, Bali, right?
This is the estimate. Yeah.
Yeah, but yeah, like the square, like the each seven is each one is 72 per square, so that means estimate value, right? Yeah. Yep. Okay.
Yep.
So 296 plus. It's because I'm writing, bro, and it takes like a little while to write, you know. So that's the repair. This is the repair cost. To like to fix the house, right?
Yeah, bro.
All right. Wait, so you're telling me it's 65K?
No. This is the at the repair price. How much you had to invest into the property?
65K.
This is how much. If I was an investor, I'd invest this much into the property. This is just an example.
No. That's if you want to repair it. That's how much you're gonna pay. 65K, right? I feel like 65K is way too much, though.
No, this is an example, bro. This is showing okay, how to get the ERV.
All right. Yeah.
We do that at the repair price, and then you get your ERV. Okay.
Yeah, I'll go look. 120, 196.
All right,
got it.
If you want to get your max available offer, times that by 0.7.
So that's for the what?
To get your max available offer, you times that by 0.7 up here. Look.
0.7. What does 0.7 have to do? What does the 0.7 do?
All right, so basically, it helps you get your max available offer. So this is how much you're going to, like, to make it, how do I say, make sense for the buyer. This is this is going to be your max available offer for you to be like, oh, I'm going to sell it to the buyer. Well, first of all, look, like I said, you don't use the max available offer at all. This is the last, like, the max available offer is for the seller. You're going to tell this guy, like, yeah, 84 flat. If you can't negotiate around and he's not as motivated, but you're trying to get the deal, you'll be like, yeah, I want 84 flat. But realistically, you're never supposed to use the max available offer. So, like I said.
Wait, so again, so you point 0.7, what is a 0.7 for? Let me write it down.
All right. I got you.
So you said the 0.7 is for what? Can you say it again?
Okay, look. 0.7 is to get your max available offer.
So, oh, to get your maximum
available offer. Just say MAO, bro. Just put the MAO.
Yeah. MAO. Yeah, but that's good, though. You gotta definitely do that because that's how much you can end up offering if you want to make profit, correct? Like for example, like if it's 55,
look, like I said, maximum available offer is never to be used. If you want to make profit and you want to get your top dollar, bro, you don't use 84. You go about the range, probably like I'll 60. Say as far as if I want to make profit off this bitch, don't go 84. Because you tell this man, yeah, the ARV is about 120, he's gonna be like 84. I'm gonna
pay for that shit.
Yeah, plus if you want to make, because this is what you're going to get to the seller. So if you want to make any profit, you won't be like, man, I want to make like 10 bands off this bitch. So you're going to be like, hey,
I have a question. Eight? You're always going to multiply it by seven?
No, that's not always the case. I say only do it when you have like how do I say? If it's as low as square foot, if it's 2,500, then I'll say do 0.7. If past that, no. You a little more off that bitch.
So you said that hold for like 60. Why didn't you try it out and try to contact the seller for that one?
I might.
Might as well that you right now right here and show me how. So I can learn.
As far as this, you can probably take this deal off my hands because I'm already working with her for one of her other properties. As far as this property,
if I'm not from there.
Oh, you can.
Huh?
Where you're from, bro. Or you have to email her the contract. You'll have to email Ashley the contract and she will sign that shit. And then she will send it back to you. Then you have to email. I'm in contract to the buyer, and you'll sign it, and then you'll get your pay, bro. It'll be to you, or you'll get a check.
Damn, I never done. Like, could you show me, bro? Whenever you do like a step, like whenever you find when you find a property, and you do the estimate, you do the square foot, and you do everything like calculation and everything, and then you go to the next step of buyer and shit.
Yeah, but look at that course I sent you, bro. You'll learn a lot from it. When I first started wholesaling, bro, that's what I looked into that course. But look how shitty this basement is, bro. It's just all types of shit, bro.
Yo, send me that too, bro.
Yeah, every bucket, bro. Send me the same course too, bro. Fuck it.
I got you.
And we all trying to learn. I'm not hitting on no one. I'm proud, bro. I'm thankful for you for helping, bro, for not being greedy, bro.
Of course not, bro. We all got, bro.